good to be here again, and I want to greet you in the precious name of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Wherever you are watching, may God bless you, may God keep you, may God make His face to shine on you. I pray that today will be a blessed day for you as we examine some of the things that are going on today in our Christian life, and I believe that even as you are joining us, you'll be blessed mightily with this wonderful time. I want to just look today at a very important scripture, important topic rather, what people are going through this pandemic, because sometimes I don't want to forget anybody. I don't want people to think that what they are going through, we forget them or we're not interested. So I want to talk about today. I want to talk about loneliness, how to stand against loneliness. What is it actually, and how do we stand against that lonely spirit that want to take over your life and destroy your attention for the Lord? Let me just start with a word of prayer. Lord Jesus, I pray for those who are watching, those who are listening, that Lord, you touch your heart, Lord. Times like this demand that we come together and share our thoughts and our hearts, and above all, Lord Jesus, also bring into perspective things that you are doing in our lives. No matter what is going on, Lord, you are still Lord Jesus. You are still King of glory. You are still the Almighty God. You are still the I am that I am. So, Lord, I pray that you will bless your people today and minister to them as they are coming to full understanding of what you have for them. I know that there's a brother there, a sister there who is feeling this topic today. And Lord, I pray you touch their, you minister to them in Jesus' name. Amen. Certain times like we are living in, when the people suddenly begin to lose their livelihood, their job, and what they've all lived their life for. All of a sudden, it looks like the job is no longer there. It looks like the livelihood or the things that they've always got used to is actually disappearing because of the pandemic. It looks like all of a sudden that they don't have any more hope. And sometimes we take it for granted, hope, but hope is a very powerful thing. And sometimes people do not have hope anymore, and it can cause a lot of anxiety, it can cause a lot of loneliness. So today I want to look at this subject in a very, very biblical way. First of all, I want to say that loneliness, is defined as that detachment, that state of mind, where you feel that every other thing that goes around you is vague. When you look around and see that nobody cares and all, and it looks like loneliness has set in. So loneliness can be a state of mind, it can be a condition of the soul, it can also be a situation of thoughts and mind and action as well. But I want to look at loneliness from the point of view of the biblical one. I'm not a psychologist, I'm not a psychotherapist, but I'm just a child of God, a pastor. I want to talk about this important subject with you. When you begin to look at society today, especially what we're going through in the last 6 or 5 months or so, everyone is anxious. People are wondering what has happened, and all of a sudden, the lifestyle you used to live, your beautiful home, your beautiful family, and the people you used to visit and have time with, all of a sudden they all disappear. They vanish away. It can cause anxiety, and that can cause loneliness. So all of a sudden you find yourself in the midst of a situation whereby you don't know what to do. Loneliness can set in. It can be a very, very trying time. And so I don't know who I'm speaking to right now, but I want to just assure you from the on-go that God understands what loneliness means. Let me read to you from the Word of God, the book of Psalm chapter 63, verse 1. I try as much as possible to just read one or two verses of scripture so to expand on. The Psalm of David, when he was in the wilderness of Judah, Psalm 63, verse 1, and the Psalm says, "Oh God, thou art my God, early will I seek thee. My soul thirsted for thee, my flesh longed for thee in a dry and weary land where no water is." What a lonely moment. In a dry and weary land, in a place where there is no water, in a place where the friendship, where the friends who are supposed to comfort you are not there, in a weary land, in a land. When you look around and say, there's people who are supposed to be there are not there. You see, at the cross, Jesus experienced the most tremendous loneliness in the world had ever known. At that very moment when Jesus said, my God, why has thou forsaken me? Was the most loneliest time in the life of our Lord and our Savior. The loneliness he felt at that time was so thick because he felt that the Lord God Almighty had forsaken him. That God Almighty has left him. That God Almighty, the Father, the Son, the Spirit. So loneliness can set in. And people can go into an emotional area whereby they don't know what to do or where to turn again. Some of these things, because of what is going on today, can cause deep issues in people's lives. So I want you to know from the very onset that Jesus knows what loneliness means. He knows what it means to have a loneliness without the Father and the Son and the Spirit of God. He knows exactly what it means to be separated from the Father. Because he said, my God, you forsook me. You left me alone. I'm all alone now. I'm all on my own. So you left me, Father. But I come to realize that you can be. Because one of the myths people have is that, I'm not married, so I'm alone. My kids left me, so I'm alone. I want to say one thing very clear. You can be in a crowd of people and be alone. You can be married and be alone. You can have you can be wealthy and very rich and very prosperous and be the most top class person and still be alone. Loneliness it does not segregate between richness or poverty or color or creed. No, you can have the most affluent life. You can have the most beautiful life and still be alone. You can be alone in your marriage. You can be alone in your crowd. You can be alone among your children. You can be alone among the higher society class you are in. And so loneliness does not distinguish between those things. But I want to say very clearly that loneliness can lead to self-pity. And that is why I want to really talk about loneliness, that God Almighty can help us out of this loneliness. He can give us the grace and the strength. Like I said before, I'm not a psychologist, I'm a pastor, because I believe that God Almighty has got the power to deliver us and help us out of that lonely life. You may be at this point in time all with your husband and maybe forsaking you or your wife, and you feel alone because all of a sudden it's not there, and you wonder to yourself, what am I going to do right now? Because the associations you do, the lifestyle, the behavioral pattern you do have left, and you wonder, what do I do right now? Can I just encourage you right now to remember that you are not alone on this as well, that Jesus Christ had the same situation as well. There was a time when at that cross where he looked and they said he was all alone, separated from the Father God, separated from the Holy Spirit, and all alone. So friend, that's an assurance for us that we are not alone in this. We are not fighting loneliness alone. We are not fighting the depression, the despair alone. And I want to be very, very honest with you that sometimes even among church brethren you can be alone. Even among the best people around the world, you can be alone. Even among the people that seem to love you most, you can be alone. And that loneliness can creep into your heart. You can cry out and cry out and cry out and seem that there is nobody there to answer you. You can look around and say, but what have I done wrong? You can even ask questions and there is no answer to your questions. Loneliness can deep into your soul, into your spirit. It can be so intense that the only way you can feel, you shout out, you cry out. And that is why when people can't take it anymore, they check out. They do self-harm, they go to alcohol, they go to abusive situations. So many of these can happen. I begin to wonder, why are people so abusive? Why are people so this and that? Because sometimes the loneliness of their soul, the emptiness of their soul can be so deep, they don't know where to turn. You know, somebody said, I want to get married so I don't be alone. I can understand your perspective, but I just want to say that there are many people in their marriage, they are still alone in their marriage. There are many people in their family circle, in their wedding circle, they are still alone. So loneliness does not distinguish between all those. That is why today the word of the living God, when the psalmist says, in the dry and weary land, I felt all alone. When Jesus said, Father, Father, why has thou forsaken me? But there is a cure for loneliness. There is a way we can all beat it together. There is no reason why you should contemplate self-harm or commit suicide because you feel all alone. There's no reason why you should take away the very take your life away because you're all alone. There's a victory that can come to you. You can turn your loneliness into an action. You can stand firm in the glory of God. You can march on from glory to glory. You can lift up your hands and say, loneliness will not get a both of you. But Pastor, I'm in my big house. I'm all here. You can have the joy of the Lord in your house, wherever you are. You can have the peace of God. You can have the grace of God, the mercy of God, the power of God in you. And that loneliness cannot be able to overcome you. The way I look at it, it's like a load of issues, a load of problems coming. And sometimes what we do, we start blaming other people. Oh, my pastor did not call me. My deacon did not call me. My archbishop did not call me. Nobody cares about me. We make up lies, which is not true. People do care about you because you feel all alone. You want to be able to justify it. Oh, nobody cares about where are all the people of the church? Friend, they are still there. The people are there. It's just that the lonely spirit have come into you to close your eyes to some of the wonderful things the people of the church or the people of the community are doing for you. That is why I want to challenge you right now that there is a cure for loneliness. You can stand firm in the midst of that. You can take a stand and say, I am not going to let this thing defeat me. It's a choice you make on a day-to-day basis. I was talking to a young man and not too long ago, and I said to him, young man, I don't know what it means to be depressed. He looked at me and said, what do you mean? I said, because every day of my life, I'm connected so much to the Father. There's a connection with me and the Father. When I go to prayer, I receive strength, I receive wisdom, I receive grace, I receive instruction. I said, because of my connection to the Father. And the young man looked at me and said, oh, I want that connection. Because I want to have a connection whereby somebody can be there for me. You know what the Bible says? If your father, if your mother forsake you, the Lord will pick you up. You know what the Bible says? Unless the Lord build the city, they build in vain their beauty. That is why I'm telling you that even though there are a crowd of people that call you every day, you can still be alone. That's why I'm saying to you that even though you have fathers and mothers and children, and everybody that attempt to be happy with you, you can still be alone. That is why it's so important to remember that unless the Lord God Almighty build you up, who can build you up? Sometimes, you need to be able to encourage yourself in the Lord your God. Sometimes you need to be able to lift up your eyes and say, God, you are my strength, you are my king, you are my everything. So that you need to be able to look past all the obstacles of life, all the difficulties of life, and stand firm and thank God for what God is doing in your life. Sometimes you're going to be able to look above or beyond or above the problems of life. You see, there's a problem of life, and there's a fact of life are very different things. A fact of life is that, you know, somebody can die, and when somebody dies, what do you do? Is a fact of life. You can't do anything about it. But the problem of life is a problem can come. That problem doesn't mean you have to. You can solve the problem. You can overcome the problem. You can solve that problem. So fact of life is there and problem of life is there. But you see, what we do is that we mix them together. When there's a problem, we begin to feel that nobody loves us anymore. Nobody cares about us. That's a lie of the devil. God still loves you. God still cares about you. God still cares about you. He takes care of his own people. A friend, there are other people in the world that cares about you. They just love you. They just care so much for you. And that is why it's so important not to put your shield and put a big mask, a big shield and say, nobody loves me. Nobody cares for me. No, it's not true. You are cared for. You are thought of. You are valued. You are important in the sight of other people as well. And so loneliness can come to the wealthy. It can come to the rich, the poor. It can come to different races. It does not distinguish. It doesn't say, oh, because you are green or because you are from that country, I will not touch you. No. It's something that can come. But because of the grace of God, because of the strength, you can overcome that loneliness. And that is why it's so important to begin to take in today and begin to take a fresh look at yourself. I can overcome this. Friend, I made a note here about the cure for loneliness. And I want to say this very clearly before I go into that. Loneliness is often associated with blame. My husband does not love me enough. My kids forsook me. My church does not care about me. And so on and so forth. And so we feel that on and we begin to apportion blame to that. But friend, let us stop and stop blaming people and see what it is. Loneliness can be a deep spiritual thing that can be so deep on the inside. How do we cure that? The very first thing I wrote here is nurture existing relationship. Loneliness can make us pull away from our friends. So friend, if you got friends that are important to you, you know, nurture that relationship. Make sure that relationship is stronger. You know, no matter what is going on, reach out to them. Nurture a relationship. Make it a very pressure, because loneliness can be so disastrous if you don't take care of that. And that is why the relationship around you, your friends that were there before the COVID-19, before the pandemic, reach out to them. Make sure you get closer to them. Nurture it. Make it stronger. Don't pull away from them. Don't give them. Don't pull away and say, well, I don't want it. No. It's time to nurture it. You know, friend, what I come to realize, if you do not nurture your relationship, it's not going to grow. You know, what you grow, what you nurture, what you feed, what you plant, what you water will grow. And so, friend, make sure you nurture your relationship. Make it stronger. Make it more pronounced, you know, and then make it so good that, you know, the people you are connected to, it could be your pastor,
It could be your cell leader, it could be your youth leader, it could be your women leader, it could be your prayer warrior leader, it could be anybody else, it could be your best friend, it could be your dad, your mom. Make sure that connection is stronger. Nurture it, make it stronger every week, every time, give them a call. Get that communication line stronger every day. Don't just break it and say, well, you know what? Oh, nobody cares about me. You see, the enemy likes us to have self-pity for ourselves. We go around the corner, we shed a tear. Oh, I wish I was that, I wish I was that, I wish I was married. Then you get married and you find you're still in the same situation. So the very first thing I want to say is make sure the people around you, treat them well. Treat your family well, treat your husband well, treat your wife well, treat your aunties well. Nurture that relationship, because friend, if we have a relationship that is strong, then when loneliness knocks at our door, we know how to connect, how to be able to speak to somebody, because it's so important that every one of us are connected. A friend of mine used to tell me, always said that the reason why God gave us our mouth is that we can be able to not just eating, but to discuss and share ideas and have a rapport together. Friend, you got to develop that relationship. Don't pull away from your friend. Don't pull away from your pastor. Don't pull away from your youth leader. Don't pull away from your cell leader. You know, friend, when the enemy tells you you are no good, oh, look at you, nobody cares about you, turn around and call your cell leader. Turn around and call your pastor. Turn around and call the people around you and let them hear your voice and bless the name of the Lord together. Because I believe strongly that the very, very first secret of the enemy trying to destroy is to cut you off, to pull you away. So don't let them pull you away. Don't let them take you away. Make sure your relationship are stronger every time, especially at this time of pandemic. When you are locked down, maybe something you can't even go to exercise. Maybe you are inside the house because of the stigma or the fear. So make sure that when your relationship is, you know, maintain it, make it stronger, my brother, my sister. You know, friend, I believe so much that in many, many aspects, the biggest challenge you have is to be able to keep the relationship going. You see, the Lord gave me a message many years ago. He said that the very, very thing that the enemy wants to do is to destroy your relationships. Number one, your relationship with God, with your family, with your church, and with all of them. He wants to destroy all of them. The very first time the devil was introduced to us in the Bible, what was he doing? He was destroying relationships. The very first time. That's what the enemy wants, to destroy a relationship. He wants to cut you off from your friends, from your family, from your pastor, from the people who love you most. The second thing I put here is that practice positive biblical self-truth. The Bible tells me that let the weak say I am strong. Let the poor say I am rich. Hallelujah. You're going to begin to practice it. Don't just look and say, well, you know what? It's in the world. No, speak it to yourself. Look in your mirror and say, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. The God that I serve is more than able. Quote the word of God. Speak the word of God out. Say it loud. Say it precisely. Make a big noise about the word of God. Because God's word never changes. It is the word of God that changes not. It's the word of life, the word of power, the word that brings an anointing. So friend, can I encourage you, speak biblical truth to yourself. When you are taking a shower, when you are combing your hair, say it to yourself, say, oh, look at this wonderful person that God has made. I am a child of the King. I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. When you are doing whatever you are, when you are cooking your food, say it again. Biblical truth are so important. We need to reinforce biblical truth, because you know what? The more you say it, the more you say it, the more you say it, the more you become to establish in your heart, and you begin to believe it, because God's word never changes. Hallelujah. His word is yea and amen. His word is powerful. His word can change situations. His word can bring things to pass. That is why I want to challenge you and encourage you to make sure that when the lonely spirit wants to come to you, no, reject it, stand firm, and speak the word of God in positive light. Declare biblical truth. The word of God says that he that dwelleth in the shadow of the Almighty shall abide. You know, Psalm 91, he that dwelleth on the secret of the Almighty, you shall abide. Begin to speak about it. Begin to speak about looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Begin to speak about, I believe in you. When you speak those truths, it becomes real in your life, and you take them with you. Hallelujah. And second, the third thing I want to say is that, you know, sometimes when people are lonely, the first thing they talk about is that, oh, nobody cares for me. I'm useless, I'm that. But I begin to wonder to myself, you know, Why don't you also start caring for people? Why don't you also find volunteer opportunities in your church or your community or your group, wherever you are? Why don't you, you know, sometimes people like to alienate themselves quickly. There's a youth meeting they don't want to attend. There's a prayer meeting they don't want to attend. There's a meeting for church they don't want to attend. And they alienate themselves quickly. Friend, the cure for loneliness is to get yourself involved in what your church, what your community, what your association, what your youth group, what your women's group, what your men's group are doing. Get involved. Ask the minister, what can I do? Can I lead a prayer? Can I sing a song? Can I do something? Make yourself involved. Make sure you are involved in what is happening. Don't just be a spectator and a complainer. Oh, they didn't do it well. If they didn't do it well, help them do it well then. If they don't know how to do it, then help them do it. Because friends, when you are involved, then you begin to understand the practicalities of doing these things. And apart from that, you also begin to understand more how to help each other. Because I believe strongly in my heart that the key to being a blessing, to be blessed, is to be a blessing. So you be a blessing and you be blessed. So if you are feeling that, then get in touch with your church or your and do things in your family. Volunteer to serve in your family. Volunteer to call that elderly woman and give her a call. Volunteer to be a blessing. Volunteer to pray for somebody on the phone. Volunteer to say, oh, you know what? I'm going to do something. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. Volunteer to be the Zoom prayer leader. Volunteer to be the Zoom prayer coordinator. Volunteer. When you do that, you are putting yourself all inside and you're going to begin to defeat loneliness so quickly like this. Because it's something that can destroy a man's soul if you don't take care. But if you take good care, you can begin to come out of loneliness easier. There are lots of organizations in Australia that you can contact, you can get involved in, they can help in many ways and so on. You can talk to them about all the things and all that. There's a lot of people who are looking for online job, home job. You can have a little bit to get yourself, you know, going as well. So you can contact all those organizations. Get more involved in your church group. Like I said before, get more involved in your church group. Maybe it's a women's meeting, it's a men's meeting, it's a youth group. Take an initiative and say, I want to do this for the men today. I'm going to do something for the men. I'm going to prepare a scripture and I'm going to read it and send it to the men's group. People today have gone online classes, online tutorials, online things, how to cook, how to make this. Do something that get yourself involved in all of those things. Pick up the phone and call somebody. You know, friend, this is one of the challenges. The phone is there. They are looking at the phone. Pick it up. Pick it up and call somebody and say, I just want to say thank God for your life. I just want to encourage you. I just want to hear how you are doing. I just want to thank you, that tell you that we are standing together in this pandemic. Pick up the phone. Don't just look at the phone and wait for people to call you first. You call somebody first. You talk to somebody first. You make sure that your voice is there. You make sure that the person understands that you are caring out about them. Friend, make it your job to check on others who might not have a friend. You know, friend, you also check on other people. Call somebody else. You know somebody who is passing through an issue. Call them. Make sure you check on them. Stop saying it is impossible. Nothing is impossible with God. Because with God, nothing is impossible. And the last one, have faith in God. Friend, with loneliness, our faith in God will shine stronger in the midst of the darkness. I come to realize, when I look at all the scriptures, all the men of God in the Bible, all the preachers in the Bible, the ones that have the fantastic testimony of the abundant grace of God are the ones that pass through hellish moments. Somebody once told me, said that Joseph was put in a pit. It's a P-I-T, pit, pastors in training. God trains his people in the time of adversity, in the time of deep issues, in the time when nobody said, close their case, finish them, God trains them that time. So friends, can I encourage you right now? Pick up your Bible, pick up your sword, connect with your pastor, connect with your cell group leader, connect with all of them. Don't be isolated. Isolation is one way the enemy can get to you. When I was doing my veterinary job as a veterinary manager, I remember I used to manage a massive farm. I used to remember this, and I cannot forget this story. I say it always. When we are taking care of the cows, we don't look for the cows that come to eat. No, we look for the ones that are far behind, that are struggling. They isolate themselves from the herd. That's the one we know that is sick. Friend, the enemy wants to destroy, want to distract. The first area is to cut you off, to make sure you are distracted from the rest people. So don't give him a chance. Get together with the people of God. get together in prayer, get together in reading, get together in getting involved, and let's hit loneliness exactly where it hurts and defeat loneliness. Loneliness cannot defeat you. There is no reason for you to commit suicide. You can stand strong, you can live your life, you can be a strong, victorious person, because God Almighty will give you the strength. He is the Alpha, He is the I Am that I Am. He is the great and mighty God. He is the all-glorious God. He can change your heart, He can touch your life, and that lonely spirit can be destroyed because of the anointing of God in your life. This moment, I want to pray with you. I want to encourage you to keep on tuning in, keep on standing firm. Don't let loneliness grab hold of you. People of God, again, let me just say quickly, connect with somebody. Talk to your pastor, talk to your cell leader, talk to people. Don't let the enemy isolate you. Pick up the phone and make sure that you are connected to somebody who can be able to encourage you. The biggest demonic power they want to destroy is to want to cut you off. But once you are connected, the enemy have no choice but to bow down. May God bless you, may God keep you, and may God make His face to shine upon you. I'm going to pray right now for all those who are watching and who are listening on YouTube and on Facebook. Father, this topic is not an exhaustive one. It's a scratch on the surface. But I want to pray for the people who have watched this video and who have listened. If anyone is passing through a lonely patch right now, can you stretch forth your hand with me? Let me pray with you right now. Just stretch forth your hand. Wherever you are, if that's you, I pray, Father God, that you will just touch their heart. You minister to their Father. Let your spirit go through these airwaves and touch them by your power. That, oh God, the burden of loneliness, the lonely spirit, will be replaced now by the spirit of joy, of grace, and of power. The Bible says God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love, of power, and of a sound mind, not a lonely mind. Father, help your people to stand strong, to be walking the walk, and stand firm in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. May God bless you. May God continue to guide you. If you need help in any way, please don't forget our details. Just give us a call or contact us, send us a message, and we'll be able to respond to you and see how we can be a blessing to you and pray with you. Remember, there is a cure for loneliness, and it's not suicide. God has the power to bring you out and to shine His light upon you. When the light shines in your soul, loneliness has no choice but to bow down. God bless. We'll be right back again next time. God bless you all.